This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your host, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, at any time I want to.
No, we're cooking with evil guys.
Get mad now.
What
the voice of the must be heard. Bigot, rape, and discrimination. The crime which are weakening America against you.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
Hey everybody, welcome to Openly Hostile Opinions. I'm Jay, that's Casey, and we got Ashley here again since she won the poll.
Yes, she did. Hi Ashley, how are you doing?
I'm good. I'm awesome.
She's very excited she won the poll.
It's like viewer's choice.
Yeah.
She's also going to torture us later, I'm sure. She has a game for us prepared.
Yes.
Oh yeah, it's been good times.
Yes. So Jay's back after being sick and his vasectomy.
It's vasectomy.
Whatever, Kevin. What are you doing, Kevin?
Yeah, I hope you all enjoyed Kevin last week in my absence.
Yes, Jay had his ball snip. He had his ball snip.
Man, I feel like a woman.
I've been waiting to do that all day.
And that's also for the little bitch comments last week.
Yeah,
asshole.
Yeah, I know.
I'm get to the fucking beer.
Wait, how long do you have to wait? How long do you have to wait until you can have sex again?
I'm not done waiting. 2 weeks.
Oh.
And even if I could, I wouldn't right now because it hurts like hell.
Oh, 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
I can't last 2 days.
Yeah, well.
Moving right along.
I'll describe the pain and shit after we try the beer.
All right. This week's beer, I have a picture of it here, is Great Lakes Conway's Irish Ale.
Ireland!
Yes. Has a cool little cap on. He looks like Tom Hanks for some reason. I don't know why. Does he look like Tom Hanks?
Yeah. And
the Green Mile.
Yeah. Oh my God, yes!
Yeah, he does.
I think that's where they're getting it because look at the background's even green.
It's because it's Irish, you dumbass.
Whatever. That's stereotyping.
Profiling.
Yeah.
All right. So a pint for P.A. Conway, or Pa Conway. I'm sorry. Pa Conway. Our co-owner's grandfather and policeman, an Irish policeman. Yeah, and you're talking about stereotyping. who'd likely uphold that an Irish ale with a full-bodied caramel malt flavors is just the ticket.
Just the ticket. I like how they put ticket in there with the police officer.
Hey.
Hmm.
Ain't bad.
All right, maybe.
Ashley doesn't like beer at all.
You know, that's not bad.
No, you like bad that?
That's not bad at all.
What beer did we have last time that she was on the show? The Irish.
Oh, God, I don't
wasn't
know.
Wasn't the Moe's Irish Ale, I think, like
no,
that or something.
No, it was
Red.
Red
Moe's, yeah. You like that?
That's
you didn't
not
like
bad
that,
at
but
all.
You like this?
Well, this has nice malt to it, and it's not very hoppy. It's pretty mild.
Yeah, it actually is pretty mild. It has a very good aftertaste. Like it just,
yeah, it does.
Like you get the taste, and then it slides off at really
the. I got to work at that.
It's got that caramel biscuity kind of flavor to it.
Yeah,
it's not
it does.
Bad.
Yeah, it's really not that bad.
You actually like that? I can't believe you like that.
Yeah.
Ashley likes a beer.
That's not bad.
I would drink a lot more of that.
Yeah, I would too. And that's the thing. Like we have a lot of beers on here that you wouldn't really drink more than a six pack because you'd probably, I don't know, die. But this
I
is
mean,
actually,
I could drink like two of those, I think.
Two?
Yeah.
For you, that's sloshed. Impressive.
That's a lot. For, I mean, no, it would take more than that for me to be drunk. But
yeah, I really like it. If I would rate it, I would give it... 4 Irish stereotypes out of 5.
I'm going to go 4.5. That's
really?
Probably one of my favorite ones we've had on so
yeah,
far.
It is really good. I really, really, really enjoy that. Like I said, I like the aftertaste it has afterwards. It's very delightful.
Yeah, it's good. It's not... I'm so sick of IPAs. Like the fucking hipsters and shit, they all drink IPAs.
Yeah.
Aren't you a hipster?
No. I just dress like one because...
always dressed like
that. I've always dressed that way.
Like we talked about in one show that Jay's always wore flannels, but now because of hipsters, flannels went up in price, so Jay doesn't wear them anymore.
Yeah, no, I wear hooded sweatshirts because they're cheaper.
Yeah,
because
they are cheaper.
Which you can also get. Here, take a look at this one if you're watching on YouTube.
Don't hurt your balls. I know. I think they look beautiful.
Yeah, they come out real nice. So,
a tear to my eye.
Just go to openlyhostileopinions.com, click the merch link, and you can get all sorts of shit. We have sweatshirts, T-shirts. All the T-shirts turned out pretty good, although I will recommend buy size up because they run a little small.
Yes. Yes. Very.
And they're probably going to shrink, so you should always buy a size bigger anyways.
That's the mom coming out.
Shut up.
So I assume you want to hear all about my testicles.
Yes. Yes, please okay. Tell us. No balls.
Well, the whole thing is like 45 minutes over and done. And that's from like getting back into the room and then walking back out.
It's like getting an oil
in.
Change, basically.
Sort of, kind of, except for it's a hell of a lot more painful. The doctors lied to me. They said, like, oh, it only hurts for like the first day. You're fine the next day. Bullshit. I got it done Friday and I'm still sore.
Did you get pain pills?
No, just antibiotics and Tylenol.
Did they give you a cone so you can't scratch?
Fuck you, dick.
That's what I would be. I'd be like, can I get one of those cones?
I have no desire to touch my nuts right now.
Give stitches?
Oh, yeah.
Want you see? Have stitches in your balls?
I don't know if I'm allowed to.
Oh, my.
No, you're not. No, I'm not showing you my stitches.
Is Jason watching?
they're. It's kind of swollen. It's... They're
they dissolvable, or do you?
Yeah, they're dissolvable. I don't have to go back for it. I do have to go back in a few weeks to do a recheck, and they'll test my boys and make sure my swimmers are all gone.
Did you count the stitches? How many stitches did you get? Like three.
It's two in each side.
I was gonna say it's simple.
My doctor is
they have to clip both.
Yeah. My doctor takes the belt and suspenders approach. So feel free to go ahead and clench your balls in agony at the moment. But what it was is he went in through each side. They cut a chunk of your vas deferens out.
Yes.
To try to prevent it from growing back.
Yep.
Then they cauterize it.
Yep.
Then they tie it off.
Yep.
Jesus Christ, man.
I mean, nowadays, sometimes they do what's called like a scalpel-less one. Where instead of using a scalpel and cutting a hole in there, they just jam a sharp pair of hemostats through your fucking sack and pull it out and cut it off. But, and he also takes the ends and kind of like buries them around stuff so that there's no chance of it growing back together, which is great. But, when you hear the word bury, it tends to imply that it's not, the most gentle of procedures. So, yeah, I'm a little swollen, a little sore, a little black and blue down there.
You're black and blue.
Yeah, it's a little black and blue down there.
This is great. Other people's suffering makes me happy.
I gotta say, though, like, I'm super proud of him. Like I'm serious,
here's the mother again.
Man.
Here's the mother again.
No, that's not the mother.
That's the woman in her, not
the
mother.
That's the woman. Yeah. You know, I went and had my shit all done, and I have scars on both sides of my stomach from it. And
just say they're tattoos.
But they're not. And it took, I was in surgery for 4 hours, I think.
Oh, my God.
You got yours ripped out, though, you said.
Yeah, I had my tubes completely removed.
There was no tying.
No, because if you remove them completely, this is what they told me. If you have them tied, first of all, they can come untied.
Wow. Oh.
Even if you got them burned.
Sort of like shoelaces.
Yes. Oh, okay. If you got them burned... then there's still a chance that you could have an ectopic pregnancy, which means you get pregnant up inside the tube.
Oh, my God.
Because it can't drop.
Why do we fuck with nature?
So
I can blow loads in my wife without having to use a condom.
Thank you. Exactly.
You
fucker. Or...
you wanted an answer.
They also said that a lot of cancer for women are caused up inside your tubes.
Oh, okay.
So... they were like, you know, we can just take them out now. So I was like, take this.
Did you get to
out.
Keep the tubes?
No, but I saw what they looked like.
Oh, okay.
You know what they look like?
What? Spaghetti?
Pipe cleaners.
Talking to the mic.
They have fuzz
pipe
on
cleaners.
Them?
Yeah. No!
Because when I think of pipe cleaner, I'm like thinking those little fuzzy things.
They're like super, super like thin like that. Like they're so tiny. I'm thinking tubes. Like, I'm thinking tubes.
Yeah, like beer bong tubes.
Yeah, my no. My
doctor described mine as about the size of, like, thin spaghetti.
Yeah. Like angel hair?
Yeah, like angel hair.
Angel hair.
But,
I would have asked to keep them, made it like a necklace out of them, like in Vietnam where they put ears.
All right, so funny story that you're all going to laugh at and I'm going to be embarrassed, but there's no secrets on this show.
Amen.
There's about to not be.
there's never been. How much have we talked about Casey's sex life? And no. All right, so I switched to a vegetarian diet, a lacto-ova vegetarian, if anyone cares. It means I'll eat milk.
Like, are you possessed? Holy water.
I'll do dairy or eggs is what it gets down to. And it's not because of some fucking ridiculous bullshit about the animals. Oh, the animals. It's because I'm tired of having bitch tits. And that's a great way. And I love vegetables. Mm-hmm. But it's a great way for me to cut out a shitload of calories, start improving my eating habits. However, on your first week of vegetarianism, or first couple of weeks, your system doesn't adjust to it right away.
No.
So there is a shitload of farting and diarrhea and wet farts and...
Yep. Looks like an ice cream machine coming out with the refrigeration broken.
Yeah, I haven't had a solid movement in about a week and a half.
So your balls hurt, you're shitting up fucking, you know, World War II in your butthole. Great.
Right. It gets worse because my wife took the whole day off from work and kind of made a day of this because I needed a driver for obvious reasons. It'd be a little difficult to work clutch with swollen testicles.
Are you even allowed to drink? Like, is it going to affect your testicles?
Did he say anything? I probably shouldn't be, but one beer is probably not going to hurt anything.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, I'm not really supposed to, like, take Advil. I'm supposed to do Tylenol because it doesn't thin your blood.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I have a question.
I have an answer.
So, you had to, I'm assuming, beat off before your surgery.
No. She's straight to the point.
No.
You didn't have to?
No.
They didn't check them to make sure that they were working before you went and had a surgery done?
They don't get paid to check them. They get paid to operate.
Okay, but so you're going to have to...
I have two kids. Trust me, they work fine.
Got to check the gasoline level.
Yeah, I have two kids. They work just fine.
So you're going to have to beat off, though, when you go back.
I believe you get to do that at home and take the sample in.
You know you only have like an hour, two
You
hours.
Get like 3 hours.
What do you mean you only get 3 hours?
They die.
You got to do it like 3 hours before you go into the office.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
They'll die.
Anyway.
So they got to check if they're still alive.
That totally just doesn't help my question. Never mind. Now my question's pointless.
Okay. You just wanted to talk about beating off.
I just wanted to know what they give you in that room because I know there's a room.
No, you do it. You do it at home and bring it in. Anyway, I was curious about that myself, actually. I asked questions. Anyway, so as I was saying, my wife took the whole day off. So she's dragging me to all these stores and shit, and I'm a fat guy, so like I got like some thigh sweat going down now, so I'm already kind of like embarrassed. I insisted we go home so I could clean up a little bit before we go, and we just didn't have time. So I go in there full on fat guy thigh rubbing together smell going on. That's bad enough. And my diet, you know, like I said, I'm on this vegetarian diet, so I've been farting. And
so you just sound unhappy.
Some of them are questionable. And I'm fine doing this in front of the old Jewish doctor because he's an old Jewish doctor. You don't give a fuck. He knows what it's like. We're guys. We have leaky buttholes. It is what it is. But there's
he's like that matzah. Rip my butthole apart.
There's this 20-something year old pretty little LPN who comes in to help. No, during.
Oh, okay.
I had no idea she was going to be involved in this whole thing.
Did she touch your balls?
Oh, my God, yeah. I had so much action there, you know.
Good.
Did they shave them?
No, I was instructed to do so beforehand.
Gotcha.
So that was long since taken
care
of.
Good question.
You know.
Yeah, you got
it. I got this covered.
And a quick aside here. Speaking of shaving, they tell you to shave the entire area down there in your inner thighs. So I did that. And here's the thing for you guys out there. When you're told to shave the inner areas, where do you stop exactly?
Yeah,
because I kind of had like a squared off area. It sort of looked like a patchwork quilt.
I'd say the kneecaps.
Yeah, that's where I stopped. Like the kneecaps and like halfway through the thigh. I wasn't sure where to go. So no, I went like
right here.
I went like middle of the thigh to the kneecap. You know, I wanted to make sure there was nothing in the way.
Of course, then again, I don't have anything hanging. So.
And you're a woman, and you're used to shaving, and you're not, you know, don't have a fur coat underneath
your
shorts.
Did they put you out? No, they put you under, right?
Oh, no.
Oh, they didn't?
No. Did they put you under?
Local anesthetic.
Oh, because I thought I was
put under.
I thought it'd be
funny.
Well,
yeah, they cut your fucking abdomen open.
I thought it'd been funny if you, like, shaved the doctor's name in your leg hair.
I was gonna write on my dick, not this part, but it's not big enough to hold all that. So
we got like the N.
That's what I would have done. I would have put fragile. like they do with the boxing.
So part of the whole situation is they cauterize it, right?
Yeah.
And they don't mention the fact that they have to put this giant sticker on your leg that acts as like the negative for the cautery machine.
Yeah.
So I got this sticker stuck to my leg on the part that I wasn't instructed to shave, of course. So when it's all over, they had to rip this thing off. I'm like, it was the worst. It was literally the worst part of the whole thing.
Like, what's the sticker?
The was hair. It was like this long,
the
too.
The hair being ripped off.
Yeah, all
leg.
This hair. It was like, imagine a giant Band-Aid the size of a fucking, like, a hardcover book getting ripped off your leg.
There's so much about that I want to feel bad for you for, but I've had a Brazilian wax done, so.
That was your fucking choice.
And you have to pay for that shit, even.
What do you mean? It's not covered by Medicare.
Right. Here, let me give you $60 while you make me cry for the next hour and 10 minutes.
I mean, there's other options.
What labels it as a Brazilian wax?
The whole kit and caboodle.
It's from top.
I know what a vagina looks
your
like.
Your taint is also covered, for lack of a better word. Taint.
Like, oh. Yeah.
So it's from like top through taint, like to
the
asshole.
Brazilian is not,
it's all the way.
It's not the bikini line. So it's like the whole thing.
So it's like going out of a rainforest with a machete and, you know, water so you don't.
When you're done, you look 12.
True story.
Anyway.
But it's swollen for 3 days.
Oh, anyway, so I'm getting off track here.
Sorry.
So anyway, like I said, I'm on this diet. I'm terrified of farting this whole time. And I had to bring with me, I had to purchase separately myself and bring with me what I can only describe as a testicle hammock.
What?
It's a suspensory. It kind of looks like a jockstrap, but it has a little hole for your dick to go through so you can, like, helicopter and pee. But, like
so
I said, I can...
So it's like a turtle.
Kind of, yeah. So I can only describe...
Poke it out.
I can only describe this thing as a testicle hammock. So they numb me up. They do the whole thing. You know, we're talking. I don't feel a whole lot except for some weird tuggings. And, like, you know, you get that.
That's what my one friend said. They feel the pulling.
Yeah, and you get, like, that little nausea in your stomach. You know how if you get kicked in the nuts, you get that little. Yeah,
it was blue balls, fucking cunts.
Yeah, it was sort of like that. So I can't say it was.
Don't fuck up.
I can't say it was painless, but it wasn't bad.
Uh-huh.
To get the procedure done until they rip that fucking sticker off. But anyway,
I can't believe that's the worst part.
So this suspensory is sitting in a box on top of my pants, right, which are over on the other side of the room. And the doctor asked me, hey, did you bring this? And I said, yeah, it's here. It's on top of my pants over there. So the nurse goes over to get it, and they get it, and they sew me into this thing. You're literally getting, like, sewn into it because they pack it all.
This testicle hammock.
Yes.
Okay.
They pack you all around with, like, gauze and all sorts of packing material for the weeping. For the first, like, 2 days, you have to keep this thing on, and it is the most uncomfortable thing.
I feel I know what you're talking about. I feel like we got them when like, Amanda and I, when we had our babies.
Not exactly,
no. It's vaginal mesh.
It looks like an athletic supporter, but like I said, there's a hole in it. But here's the thing. Medical device manufacturers, if you're going to do this shit, could you make elastic bands that aren't sharp on the sides?
Why would they do that?
I don't know. So anyway, it's like cutting into my leg.
Oh, that's horrible.
But so I had to spend 2 days in this thing. But here's the part I'm getting off track about. When I finally, they say, okay, sit up slowly. You know, you've been laying here. Well, under the bright lights, you'd probably be dizzy. I hopped right up. I had no problems. I was ready to go. So... Doctor brings me over my drawers and sits them there and says, okay, well, whenever you're comfortable, get ready and or get your stuff back on. You can, you know, go see the nurse on the way out and you're done.
So it was even done in the doctor's office?
Oh, yeah. It was as long as all your stuff is where it belongs, it's right in the doctor's office. So I'm looking at my underwear and my pants and I realize I have this freaking greenish brown fucking skid mark right down the middle of my underwear. So this nurse had to go over and get the suspensory that I had sitting there right in front of my fucking skid mark.
Oh, that's great. That's
great.
Don't
I turned.
Like, fold that shit up and like.
I had other things on my mind.
You're talking, this motherfucker's a vegetarian. That shit smells like broccoli.
Yeah, well, it was sitting there. And like I said, I got this freaking. I wanted to go home and straighten up first. And the wife didn't allow me because we were running all over the place. So I had this fucking streak. I don't know if the nurse saw it, but I'm pretty much thinking so. Because after the fact it was over, she talked to me a little differently.
This was the good looking one.
Yeah, I mean, she's...
attractive.
She was young.
She's decent.
She's young, like automatically.
I mean, she's right not. She's not like. She's not like the hottest chick on the face of the planet. She's a good-looking girl.
Yeah.
But it's just like, even if it was the doctor himself, if it was a female of any kind.
Yeah.
The doctor himself doesn't bother me because, guys, we know we have leaky buttholes. I don't know how women can wear like.
Well, they have leaky vaginas, so.
Well, Larry the Cable Guy said it best. I think I have a different kind of butthole than a woman because they can wear it, walk around in a thong all day long. Comes out completely clean.
True story.
It does. It comes out completely clean. I wear a pair of whitey tighties and it looks like I got drugged through the mud somewhere.
I don't know how that happened.
I don't know. Guys Jay's just have suffering. Leaky buttholes.
Jay's suffering. I love it.
I don't get it. I don't even wear underwear.
It's because you don't have dangly parts.
Yeah, we got to. And much like Casey, who wears whitey tighties for a living.
I hate anything. Times. I hate anything but whitey tighties.
Really? I had to buy them.
I hate it. I just.
What about boxer briefs?
Nope, hate them.
Yeah, I had to buy whitey tighties.
I have a couple actually. I need support. I actually right now own more briefs than I do whitey tighties, but I just hate the way your dick just is like there. There's no.
I hate having my dick just like shoved right against everything. It starts sticking.
I know, and then it sticks to your thigh, and when it peels off, it tickles. Like real bad.
I want to know what it's like to have dicks.
No, it's horrible.
Generally, we don't even think about them unless there's a reason to think about them.
Yeah, exactly.
I feel like you're always thinking about them.
No. That whole all men think about stuff, we do.
I can watch you bartend and touch yourself 4 times in 5 minutes.
Well, yeah, it's itchy skin. You got to pull it away once in a while.
All balls itch. It's a fact.
And when you're not allowed to touch them, they itch a hell of a lot more.
And it's like when it sticks to your leg and it like first peels off, it looks like bubble gum from like underneath the bleachers, and it fucking tickles, and I hate it. So whitey tighties help keep that from sticking to my leg.
But in general, we don't like think about our scrotums that often.
No.
Unless they itch, then we scratch them and we go back to whatever we're doing, and it's you know what is. But right now, my scrotum is like at the top of my mind at all times.
Right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I got stitches in it. The stitches are sharp. They kind of poke me in the leg. And here's the weirdest part: they had to do one a lot higher than the other for some reason. So I got like one up high, one down lower.
Well, that I think that solves the myth that one ball hangs lower than the other.
Oh, it certainly does. Yeah, it certainly
does.
Does
it hurt when you get a boner? Have you gotten a boner yet?
Yeah, and it doesn't hurt. No,
it doesn't hurt. No, doesn't all the skin like pull from it?
We have quite a bit of slack there.
So interesting in your take on balls and penises.
It's all,
Women are so in the dark about the whole thing.
Oh, yeah. And actually, it leads me to a question, Ashley. Do you think penises are ugly? I met a girl that loves the way penises look, and I couldn't believe it. Because I mostly hear that women love dick, but they just don't like the way they look.
Don't love the way they look. I mean, I'm not going to like...
Yeah, this girl loves the way they look.
But vaginas aren't pretty either.
Oh, I think they are. I'm thinking Arby's.
Hey, Casey.
What the fuck is that? Hey, he just showed me a picture of his testicles.
What the fuck is that?
That is the wound.
Oh, my God.
There is nothing to be seen there except for a quarter of an inch wound, but there it is.
That looks so painful.
It doesn't feel very nice.
Oh my God.
It looks like chewed up bubble gum.
That is not even swollen. Close to what, like mine was, damn. I just had like two little like.
There is no shame in this show. We just show nut sacks.
Wow.
Now, what I showed was literally like a spot this big on my.
Yeah, you would have had no idea that that's what that was.
And it's educational. So we're allowed to shave.
Oh, yeah. Here's another thing about it, too. Like I said, they have you shave the area, right? Well, you know what happens after a day or two of not shaving something? That you,
oh, fuck yeah.
You get sharp little hairs poking back up that jam directly into the irritated spot on your scrotum.
Thank God I don't mind condoms because I'd never do this in my life.
Oh, fuck condoms.
Huh? Why?
Because I use condoms.
You spoken like somebody who's never had sex without one.
I haven't.
You've never had sex without a condom?
Oh, a couple times. But I'm actually.
Then
really
you know
he was probably too
better.
Drunk to remember.
I'm too drunk to remember.
Yeah, see, I have had sex a lot without condoms, and I'm gonna tell you this much: it's much more.
See,
fun.
I don't give a fuck. Once I'm done, I'm just like, I'm in a good mood now. Whatever.
Did you just like wave her away? Is that what that was?
Yeah.
Be gone with you.
God, servant. Yeah.
You should never refrigerate red wine. It destroys the bouquet.
Yeah, I just. sex is very primitive to me. I'm just like, yeah, whatever.
It used to be. I mean, it was for a short span. Man,
this whole lovey-dovey bullshit. Nope. I'm caveman in the end. When I'm
come on, nope. You could be lovey-dovey.
No, when I'm done with you, it's like I use wet nib after eating wings. I'm done.
Why is Casey single? Let's see if we can figure it out.
Count the ways.
Hey, women have done it to me though. They've destroyed this person. So whatever.
Oh yeah, blame it on women.
I am
instead of your own damaged ass self.
I am. I'm not. Yeah, I'm damaged because of other people. Everyone goes crazy because of other people. Everyone else sucks.
Other people do suck.
Yeah, exactly. Definitely. Exactly. Exactly. Go fuck yourself, people.
Yeah.
My God.
All of you.
No, watch our show, buy our stuff.
But then go fuck yourself.
Yeah, but then go fuck yourself.
Speaking of which, I probably should give a quick shout out. We've had a lot of new subscribers lately, so thank you guys for subscribing. Yes. Mm-hmm. Thanks for watching the show. Be sure to share it with your friends. We appreciate it.
Yes.
You can check us out on all sorts of places. We got it on YouTube, we're on iTunes, we're on Google Play, we're on Stitcher, we're on TuneIn Radio.
Pornhub.
Not yet that I'm aware of, but
give
we could
time.
Be.
Yeah, give it time.
After this week's episode, hey, you can see my seeping, possibly infected wound.
Is it clearing up though? It doesn't look infected or anything?
No, it's not. It's just swollen.
Could you imagine pus coming out of that?
It does.
Oh, that's so gross.
There is weepage going on.
We're used to semen coming out of it. Who cares about pus? I'm like, more stuff come out of my dick. That's weird.
I'd rather it come out than be stuck in my sack.
I know,
I've heard
exactly.
Of that.
Yeah. And then getting infected. In oh, yeah.
I've heard of people who have had vasectomies and their ball sack is filled up with fluid because it just something happened.
Other than semen.
Yeah. Actually, that happens too. there's a thing
like an overflow.
There's a thing that happens to some guys when they get an open-ended vasectomy, they call it. Instead of like tying and cauterizing all that shit they did with mine, they leave the tube open, and what you'll end up getting is what's called a sperm granuloma, and you get this big ball.
It's like a brand of granola bar.
That's what I was thinking.
You get this.
I was kind of hungry.
Your body creates a granuloma. It calcifies something that's foreign in your body that doesn't belong there. So you get this like marble, you get this stone inside your nutsack of sperm until your body learns to attack it.
And break it down.
So after a while, people who have these open-ended vasectomies, what ends up happening is their body learns that sperm are foreign bodies, so they start attacking them. So if you had the vasectomy for a long time, getting a reversal is hard.
That is so cool. I love that.
Yeah, me too.
That is so cool.
Well, the way my doctor did this
shit. Like, you have other people in your body, and your body's like, hey, something's wrong here. I think that's fucking awesome.
Well, the way the doctor did it, I have no problems. I have nothing to worry about here. Yeah. He's done over 1,000 of these things. He's been doing them for 30 years. He's never had any complications other than a guy who didn't listen to him, had sex the first night, and his nuts swelled up like basketballs.
How? Dude. That had to hurt so bad.
I know a guy that got kicked out of a hospital because once his wife had the baby, when everyone left, they came back in and they were having sex.
Yeah. I'm just going to hold myself.
He's a fucking trooper.
Yeah, exactly. Well, this is the same guy that, this is when I worked in the meat room.
He
cut his thumb off on a bandsaw.
Oh, okay? Good.
He goes, we got to get you to the hospital right now to get that. So I can't. We're like, why? He's like, I have a date. We're like, what?
All
he
right.
He was
then.
So excited for this date. He didn't want his thumb reattached. So he just, yeah, he's missing a thumb now because he wanted to go on a date really bad.
This just got dark.
I know. And
wow.
And this was after the whole, like, his wife and shit like that, that he had sex with after she had it. I wonder why that marriage didn't work out.
I don't know.
It's fucking weird.
I don't want anything. I did not want nothing going near my vagina after giving birth.
Oh my God, you squeezed a human being out. That's the biggest dump you've ever took.
You have no idea.
You have no idea.
No, but funny story. This actually reminds me. I was hanging out laundry one day. It was actually pretty nice out. And I was in my pajamas. I wear Nintendo pajamas.
You are such a man child.
I don't give a fuck, whatever. Teen Titans Go. Anyways. And I'm hanging out laundry, and her daughter comes on the school bus, and they stop to let kids off.
How old's your daughter, Ashley?
10.
That's right. Okay.
They go, who's that weird kid hanging up laundry in his pajamas? And they knew that her daughter knew me, and they were all looking at her. She got really embarrassed.
For the record, Casey is 32.
Yeah, I don't care. Whatever.
So they referred to him as that weird kid. Casey's 32.
Yes. Abby, do you know that weird kid? And she was like...
Yeah, and she hit her face and stuff like that. So I embarrassed the shit out of her daughter. But it's like, I'm not dressing up to hang laundry out in the line. I was in my PJs.
In your defense, everything embarrasses my daughter anymore. Like,
oh, well, she's getting to that age.
Yeah.
Is it getting to the point where, do you drop her? Oh, no, duh, she takes the bus. But when you've ever dropped her off at school lately, has she got embarrassed?
Like, I can't walk. Kiss her goodbye? I can't leave the car
anymore. Okay, yeah.
Right. Like, I used to walk her to her store, you know, to her room. Mm-hmm. And then it became like I'd walk her to the door. And then it was like she would give me, like, you know, a kiss and a hug in the car.
Yeah, now
and
no
now
more of
she's
that.
Like, phew, out the door in the school. Like, don't talk to me. Look at me. I don't want anybody to know you're my mother.
Yeah.
I can't wait until my oldest daughter becomes a teenager. Because she's going to be the one that tries to wear the inappropriate clothing.
Mm-hmm.
I
mine already tries.
I
sadly, I don't have kids.
Sadly, yours is more mature than mine, and mine's 2 years older.
It's sad, though. I mean, it's sad for me. Like, I don't want to deal with it already.
But anyway, my oldest daughter's going to be the one who tries to wear the inappropriate clothes. I cannot wait. Because what I'm going to do, and I have promised her this already, is if she tries to wear something stupid to school, I'm wearing that too and dropping her.
That's what
off.
I would do. That's what I would do. I'd wear the same thing she's wearing.
I'm going to wear a mini skirt and walk her to school. Yeah.
That is awesome.
Yeah.
I have no shame.
That is parenting. That is parenting.
Here's the thing. I've put myself out there on this show and everywhere else at this point.
You showed us our nuts, so yeah.
I've been a freelance writer.
I feel closer with you now.
I've been a freelance writer for years. All my shit's been public. I'm not afraid anymore. Yeah. I don't care. I have no more shame. So
who gives a fuck?
My daughter does.
Oh, she's got a lot of it.
See, I have no shame.
Yeah.
I don't give a shit. I put everything out there for you people for your enjoyment. I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, there was a guy that this girl was wearing too short of shorts. He'd buy her pants, and she kept cutting them shorter. So he took a pair of her pants and walked around in them and made her hold his hand and walked around Walmart.
Oh, yeah. I'll do it.
That's parenting.
Yeah.
I'll do it.
I totally am okay with that.
Yeah, exactly. Whatever.
Yeah, I have no problem with that. I'm already looking forward to it. Like I said, I have no shame. You can't embarrass me. I don't care. Nothing bothers
me. Jay's looking forward to it. I can't wait till my daughter fucks up. So I can have some fun.
There's so little fun as a parent. Oh, it's so hard because you're responsible for somebody's entire well-being.
Nah.
If you screw up, if your kid turns into a stripper or a serial killer, it's all
fault.
On you.
It's you.
Everybody looks at you. So,
what kind of parents did she have?
I know.
Where was the mother when they were growing up? That's the shit that you hear.
That's why people keep trying to like pawn it off on, oh, what kind of music did they listen to? What kind of video games were they playing? Yeah. Because the parents are like, I didn't do this. I swear to God.
This was not me.
Times are tough, man. You got to do what you got to do, man.
I have no shame. I don't give a fuck.
I'd do the same thing because, you know, a lot of people, you beat your kids, you get yelled at. So, you know what?
Oh, I whoop my kid's ass and I'm unapologetic.
You're totally right, though. You beat your kid in public, you get yelled at. Mm. You don't beat your kid in public, people yell at you.
Yep.
Please tell me, as a mother, what the hell am I supposed to do to punish my kid? Which way's right? Because
Be your own mother. People think parenting is perfect. It's not. It's one of the worst and hardest things you'll ever go through in your life.
Well,
and I'm not even a parent, and I realize that.
I'll tell you one thing. I'll tell you right now what the difference... I got to be real vague about this, too, because... I don't know if these people watch the show or not, but it's a true life story. I have a kid. I'm not even going to tell you which one. I have a kid in school, and she's having trouble with this little boy. And she's been having trouble with this little boy since she was a kindergartner. Okay? So this little boy and her have had...
Married.
What?
They're going to get married.
They better fucking not. I'll kill the little bastard. Anyway, she's having trouble with this little boy, and his mother is a psychologist.
But that's common, you know.
But here's the thing. He acts like a fucking heathen. He punched her in the vagina the other day.
Oh, my God.
Hadouken.
Hold on.
It wasn't enough.
Falcon punch.
It wasn't enough to hurt her in any way.
That's not the point.
I know that. But what I'm saying is this kid's mom is a psychologist, which means she, I guarantee she's like, oh, we can't have negative reinforcement.
Oh, God.
That kid would damaging. Get some negative reinforcement
I would
from
beat
me.
The that fuck out of that
and
kid.
This is why psychologists, I can't give them credit, especially the newer ones, because their head is filled with nonsense bullshit like that. Mm-hmm.
I told my daughter that you, if he does that ever again, ever. Now I'll tell you this. The school did what they had to do. They took care of it. It's handled, and I'm not going to go into details, but it's handled. It was a pretty good part. It was a pretty good punishment, but I told my daughter if this ever happens
it's like,
again,
it's like a throw punch, but to the vagina. You're like boom, you're done.
I told her if it ever happens again, you punch him as hard as you can in the face.
Yeah,
oh god, yeah.
And she's like, but I'll get in trouble. I said, oh, I don't care. I will handle that.
He punched you in the vagina.
So if that ever happens again, you punch him as hard as you can in the face. You make him bleed, and I will handle.
Being that I know which little girl it is, she can handle her own.
You know who?
Yes,
it is.
She can.
Oh, okay,
she can handle her own.
Shut up, both of you. I don't want troubles here.
I don't want to.
Because I talked
you
to
can't
this.
Say about getting punched in the vagina. We cannot not talk.
I know that I talked to this person's parents, and they mean well. They just. Sometimes you need another kid to whoop someone's ass.
You do.
Yeah. Sometimes if you're a dick or you're a bully or you're whatever word you need to say, someone needs to whoop your ass, and then you learn what's appropriate behavior in society.
Yeah, I just read a great article yesterday. It was like one of the biggest lies ever taught in school is that bully won't be tolerated. It's bullshit.
Oh,
yeah.
It is bullshit.
It is bullshit. Oh, it's absolutely, it was a great article.
And in the same breath as bullying won't be tolerated, they'll also... tell it or give you shit for tattletaling.
Yep.
So what are you supposed to do?
Exactly.
So like I said, I taught my kids, like, somebody ever does anything like that, I mean, I'm not saying if they shove you in the playground, go tell a teacher. If they hit you in the vagina, you punch them in the face as hard as you fucking can.
I know.
You make them bleed, and that will get the teacher's attention. Why'd fucking, you do that? Well, he
this
did
is
this.
Why.
Fucking stone cold stunner him.
Yeah.
That is right.
And then when I come into school, because I'm going to get hauled into the principal's office too, as a parent, I'm going to say, well, if he had learned to keep his hands to him, fuck himself, she wouldn't have hit him in the face.
I know, exactly.
I think he got what he had coming to him.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And that's you got to stick up for yourself.
Because if I had touched another girl in the vagina at that age, they'd have punched me in the face, and I'd have deserved it.
The teacher would have punched you in the face back then.
Quite possibly.
Yeah.
I mean, seriously.
Yeah. I've known teachers that a guy was fucking with them, one of my friends or something like that. He grabbed him by the throat and put him against the wall. You know what that kid did? Never talk to the teacher like that ever again.
I actually know a kid or a teacher who did that to a football player, and then the football player whooped his ass.
Yeah, I've also, yeah.
And then that teacher got suspended.
There's a risk.
Yeah, there is a risk. You
know. The teacher got suspended for putting his hands on a kid, so that was pretty funny.
Kids are irrational. They're not very... They just do random things, and they need to be put in their place. They just do.
He was being a cockhead. Like, I remember he was a football player. Yeah. He was being a cockhead, and his teacher decided he was going to be king shit and put him against the locker. This kid was a football player, and he was twice as big as this guy, and whooped his ass.
Falcon punch.
Oh, my God. Like, the teacher, even if he wasn't suspended, wouldn't have showed up to school for a while just to lick his wounds.
Yeah. Wow. See, this is why I can't have kids. It's just too much. Fucking, this is happening, you know, they just, you know, teachers just fuck your kids now. That's a normal thing.
So many.
I know, that's just a normal
You know what,
thing.
Though? I always hear about the ones you always hear about anymore are the female teachers fucking the male students.
Yeah.
Where were they when I was in school?
And it's not even a couple. It's like
we are the same age. And there were multiple teachers where I went to school. Where
yeah, but it was usually dudes. When I was a kid, the females never fucked the kids.
I had a weird teacher.
At least they weren't interested in me.
We had three females.
I had a weird teacher that he put, like, middle of winter, 20 degrees outside, he put fans on. He'd sit all the girls in the front of the class and put fans on them. Yeah. I actually egged his house once.
I had an alcoholic teacher.
I had an alcoholic.
I had a driver's ed teacher who got a bunch of DUIs.
That's awesome. That's great.
That's awesome. That is
somebody my mom knows, actually.
Yeah, our metal shop teacher was an alcoholic. He'd go, hey, do this, and you'd hear him go back in his office, hear the drawer open, the bottle hit the table. Yeah, we'd be chewing tobacco and fucking spitting it everywhere. He didn't give a fuck.
Best thing in the world, I had a metal shop teacher who was at the end, his last year of his career, and he didn't give a shit.
Oh, I love it.
It was so much fun there.
Yeah, actually, my creative writing teacher, she was a female. She married a kid 2 years older than me. And she got fired because they did not wait until after he graduated to have their relations.
That's so awesome.
But, hey, in all seriousness, she was 22.
Yeah.
If she was 22 and he was 19, there's no issue there.
Yeah.
Whatever. But that's our teacher.
So what?
That's what I said. You can't put a 22-year-old in a room of 19-year-olds and 18-year-olds and not expect a relationship to form.
Microphone.
What about it?
You keep...
Sorry.
She's chicken heading.
Let her rant, damn
it. I feel like I have to talk to both of you.
Talk to the camera. These are the people listening.
Anyways.
That's the worst part about this is trying to learn not to...
Move?
Not to chicken head.
That's what the headphones are for, so we can hear ourselves like...
Right.
Drift away. One more time.
Drift away.
We better get to this game or we ain't going to have time to play it.
Yeah. Oh, this is good times.
Yeah, actually, yeah, we do have a game. And Ashley did this all by herself.
I did.
Okay, so tell us about this game because Casey and I are completely in the dark.
Yeah, we have no idea. She said that she was doing this, so we have no idea. We do have punishment for it. That's the only thing we did have set up.
So, basically, I asked Amanda 8 questions about your relationship.
Oh, yes. This is
bitch did. We were going to do this to you and Jason. This bitch.
We were actually. We were going to bring both you and Jason.
Son of a bitch.
But that can be like the second edition. See?
Wait a minute. So I'm the only one playing?
No. And since Casey's a loser and doesn't have a significant other.
Damn right.
I asked Ron.
Okay. All right. That's funny. All right. So this when we get something wrong, we are going to get... Now, this company sent me this as a sample, so thank you. QCAN. QCAN Plus fermented soy beverage with no added artificial preservatives or colors, 100% natural.
So basically it's good for you, so it's going to taste like shit.
Oh my God.
I think it's going to give them
purified water, non-GMO, all natural fermented soy, milk powder, rock sugar, coffee, natural and artificial flavors.
Is there caffeine in that?
Probably a little.
Oh dude, come on. Wait, man.
Coffee and all natural means diarrhea.
I
gotta go like places later. I'm going to be
You're going to be really awake
and
for
Jay's
it.
A vegetarian, so he's going to be fucking Skidmark City over here.
There's nothing in here that's not vegetarian. Product of China, distributed by BESO Biological Research. Biological Research Incorporated.
So it was made in a lab, basically.
In China.
This is great.
With China's all natural resources.
Because they're a great country.
Oh my God, you open this up with like a... I don't even know how to open this.
What?
It looks like medicine. I'm
what
afraid.
Is it, a chastity belt? What the fuck is going on there?
Oh my God, it's got a rubber stopper.
Oh, looks like a condom.
It's got a fucking rubber stopper. I really hope I don't miss any of these because this doesn't...
Oh, we're going.
Oh, there was a... Yeah, oh, that does not smell good. Casey, smell that.
What's it smell like?
Oh, sour milk.
Oh, dude.
Not expired, I swear.
It looks like Nesquik.
For a second, I thought that it was chocolatey, but then that sour came out.
Oh, yeah. It smells like dog food, sort of.
How many questions are these?
8 each. Oh, and I have them go on every other. So that
and there's soy working. In it, so there's natural estrogen in that, so you're growing more man tits. Just let you know.
Yeah, I think you need to do more than one.
First
off, fermented is not really... It undoes all that. But anyway, continue. All right, go with the goddamn game.
All right, so...
He's like, let's get this over with.
So since that was the first time that I did this with the questions, some of them were easy.
First off, she was supposed to come up with a game that I thought was great called Sex Position or Dance Move, but apparently she decided to fuck with me. All right,
this is great. That's embarrassed, Jay.
Yeah, so like question one is for Jay. How and where did you and Amanda first meet?
We met in Ohio. We met in Barberton, Ohio at her graduation in Wadsworth, I believe.
And how did you meet her?
How did I meet her? I drove my ass there and met her.
How did you meet her originally? Like, how did you get in
touch? I think this is did you first talk to her?
Yes.
Oh, how did I first talk to her? On MySpace, on the internet.
Perfect. Okay. There you go.
Ding, 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 ding.
Okay. See, though, that's not really meeting someone.
Yeah. I knew where she was going, though.
Saw her at her graduation.
Yeah, but how you met her.
Okay, all right, whatever.
I mean, she got it right away. She was like, internet.
Well, meat is a...
This is Ashley's way to hate men.
All right, whatever. Next question. This one's for you, asshole.
Yep, this is Casey.
Oh, great.
I asked Ron these questions. So I said to Ron, what food does Casey eat most at the tavern?
Chicken.
Yeah, that's it.
I could have told you that one.
Yep. Ron always
he
makes
likes
fun.
The cock.
Cock-a-doodle-doo. What do gay chickens say? Any cock will do.
Any cock will do.
I love how decorated you made these. It's quite cute, actually.
I know. Yeah,
I
named them.
Is that wallpaper?
It's scrapbook paper.
Okay.
All right, next question.
And then I put the openly hostile questions.
First edition.
Yeah.
We should sell these, put them on the bookshelves.
See?
All right, next question.
Question number two. Your worst date with Amanda ever.
Oh.
Our worst date?
Yep.
Probably be our first one just because she was so damn nervous. We went to a little restaurant next to her dad's house that had they were doing a car show there. And I ordered a Reuben and she refused to eat because she was too damn nervous.
That's a girl. Yeah.
That's a girl.
Yeah. It was pretty cool. I kept singing her Elvis songs.
I'm going to give it to you. She said that it was your first date.
Yeah.
Was the worst one, but because you gave her mother the wrong number.
No, I did not. Let me explain. Let me explain. I gave her brother-in-law, who wasn't married to his sister at the time, but anyway, they were dating. I gave her my phone number, and he put it in his phone incorrectly. I gave the correct number. I know my own fucking phone number. And then we were out for a while, and they kept trying to call us because, for whatever reason, because we were taking too long, I guess. And they couldn't get through because the number wasn't valid. Well, I gave him the correct number. He put it in his phone wrong.
So this first date was in Ohio?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was the first real date. Like, we had talked to each other for quite a while before that, but the actual date.
Yeah, you could tell it was a while ago because he'd been on MySpace.
Back when that was relevant.
Yeah, MySpace was the shit back in the day.
Briefly. All right. All right, Casey.
Okay.
According to Ron, what is the latest thing you feel Casey has wasted his money on?
A hooker. No, I'm joking.
He's going to get this wrong.
According to Ron?
Yep.
I have no fun. Dude, that's such a tough question. I don't fucking know. Ron's crazy.
It's an excellent answer, though. It's an excellent answer.
I'm thinking of prostitute.
Did you ever buy a prostitute?
I'm not talking about it.
No, he hasn't, which makes this a horrible idea.
That's all I can think that Rob would say as a prostitute.
Well, you're wrong.
What the hell could I waste money on?
Vegan meal.
That's an excellent answer, is it not?
Dude, Ron, that was great. I'll drink this shit. That was fucking funny. That was fucking funny.
I don't even have coffee to wash this down.
That was fucking funny.
I better not answer anything wrong.
That was really good. Okay. Oh, Jesus. It smells like old Nesquik.
It looks gross. It looks like shit in it.
Just drink it.
Oh, my God.
Is it real bad?
I've never tasted something like that in my life, dude. Never.
What's it taste like?
I don't know.
It tastes like Q-can fermented soy beverage.
Dude, I never thought your mouth could taste stuff like that.
My balls hurt. Stop making me laugh. Oh,
Jesus Christ, dude. There's nothing I've ever tasted like that in my life. I'm shaking. I don't know. I have no idea. Old chalk. Can chalk get moldy?
I don't know. I'm trying real hard not to look at the answers here, but you're not exactly making this easy.
Sorry. Thanks for being honest.
Yeah, I'm trying not to look at answers here. So.
Okay.
Man, that's horrible.
I can't really breathe now, but what is Amanda's favorite color?
Teal.
This is bullshit.
No question, teal.
All right, so I asked Ron, what does Casey like best about work?
The alcohol.
Do you try to answer these?
Dude, like, the last one, like, I can't, hold on, give me a sec. Read the question again.
Get that close
I'm not to looking. You. I'm not looking because I know she's being really bad at it. What? Read the question again.
What does Casey like best about work?
I don't, there's so much about work.
That's a good answer. It's a good answer.
The people?
You hate people.
We both know not the answer.
What would you say after a good night? What would you say is the best part of it?
Money?
All right. We gave him every chance.
What do you?
The adrenaline rush after a rush.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Even though I can't sleep.
Damn it. Would you be? I'm trying to be honest.
I should have thought this through better.
Yeah, you did. You should have.
All right. Well, Casey's got to die.
Hold on. I need some water first. This stuff is fucking. It.
At least you have water. I got nothing. I feel
like we should be able to smoke in here.
No. When I drink this, I feel like my tongue's sticking out and someone's just spray painting it. It's horrible.
It's got a coating, does it?
Yes, a very bad coating.
Is it like on your teeth?
No, your tongue. Oh, dude, it's like old rubber. It's like eating a tire.
I bet you they had no idea what they were sending me this for.
No, it's god awful.
All right. What does Amanda find the most physically attractive about you?
Ooh. I'm saying man boobs.
Shit.
Oh, that's cute.
That is cute.
Has she ever told you this, to be fair?
Probably not.
I bet she has.
Did she tell you that she has?
No.
No.
Oh, I don't know.
This isn't even the best question yet.
Oh, it gets good.
Okay. She's complimented my blue eyes. Let's go with that.
Fuck you.
That's it, man.
Fuck you. God damn it.
I'd be awesome in the newlywed game.
He's going to have to drink again. This is going to happen.
I feel like this game is like pinned against me.
Oh, that's a bullshit. That's a bullshit answer.
It wasn't even fair when he answered it. I was like, you can't.
You know what? If he answers this one, I'm going to give it to him.
Okay.
Because that would be the answer.
I asked Ron, who would win a fight between Batman and Spider-Man? I will forewarn you and say. He did not give either one as an answer.
See, that's bullshit, Dad.
Yeah, that's bullshit.
Yeah, that's bullshit, Dad, because I can't win no matter what.
So, we just had like a side bar here. So,
if he says the one I pointed to, I would give it to him.
All right. I say Batman, and I'll explain why. Because I think he would do the same thing as the Punisher did. The Punisher just made bug spray and killed him. Well, he was going to kill him. The Punisher just made bug spray and was like, took his mask off. He was like, oh, you're just a kid. I'm not going to kill you. I think Batman would have done the same thing.
That's why I said if it was Batman, I'll give it to you. Because that's smart. The answer you would give.
He said Andre the Giant.
What?
I don't make this up. I mean, I kind of did, but.
All right, next question.
Question 5.
I'm doing good so far. This isn't good. This isn't good. I can tell from the laughing.
Oh, this is great.
How does Amanda let you know when she wants sex?
Oh, man. Honestly, she doesn't. But let me think here.
Oh, man, this is great.
This might be a learning moment for you.
Yeah. Like, once you figure this out, you're going to have a lot more.
The whole thing's changing.
She wrestles around with me usually.
That's your final answer?
I guess. What's the answer?
Grab his junk or put my boobs in his face.
That's so...
She doesn't do that nearly enough, so apparently...
Enjoy.
Well, she doesn't want sex that often.
Apparently not. I've had worse.
Oh, fuck you. Fuck you.
It does leave a coating on your mouth, though.
I know, doesn't it?
Do I have anything to rinse this out? Nope.
Yeah, see, it's fucking horrible, isn't it? That coating is god awful.
I'm good. I have enough coffee here to get through, I think. Unless I answer a lot wrong.
What is the best advice Ron has ever given you?
Use a condom. I would say... Don't make excuses in life because life doesn't give you excuses.
I would agree with you, but that's not the answer he gave.
Is this fucking, dude, are these even reliable answers?
I feel like that's reliable.
I would agree with that being good advice.
That's all I can think of.
Stay away from Ashley G.
Oh, God. Jesus. See, this isn't even fair.
Who's Ashley G?
Don't worry about it. Pour that drink. Just pour that in there.
I said...
The spray paint.
I said, wow, is it similar to when you told Jason H. to stay away from Ashley B.?
I never said that. I just didn't think it would turn into
We just said Jason was a little bitch after all that shit he talked, and then all of a sudden you get with him, and now all of a sudden he's little Mr. Flowers and Rainbows and fucking ponies and shit.
I love you, Ashley.
I'm not laughing because then my ponies and rainbows will stop.
There's a lot more questions there.
There's really not.
There's eight each.
I don't like this.
On a scale of 1 to 10, Amanda rated your sex life as a...
I don't know, a 4?
Give yourself more credit than that. Come on.
An 8?
Not that much credit.
A 6.
A 7.
Drink up, bitch.
Nobody gets a 10. You need to know that, right?
I don't wanna.
I'll give Jason a 9.
Yeah, see, it doesn't taste bad. It's just that coating.
Yeah, it's weird.
It's fucking horrible. Ashley should just take a shot for being a bitch.
Oh, God, I just smelled it too close to my face. No.
Oh. What are you doing? So you don't have to taste it.
No, it didn't work.
See, yeah, it's fucking god-awful. All right, moving right along.
Okay. I asked Ron, what is an important skill everyone should have? Don't read into this too much.
Don't read into this. Oh, man, that's a tough one. What is an important skill every person should have?
It's really general.
It's a very generic general answer.
A good work ethic.
Or reading.
I love this. I'm getting a couple of shots, but he's fucking
reading?
It's a good skill everyone should have.
You should thank Ron for your...
Oh my God. The vegan thing was hilarious.
The bottle of this that you've pretty much taken in by yourself.
That has, I hope, not too much caffeine in it, because I'm going to see sounds.
Look, he's got 2 questions left. This wasn't so bad.
God, the coding.
Okay, Jay, who usually gets their way, you or Amanda?
Amanda will say me, and I will say her, so this is kind of a moot point.
Well, now you got to remember, this is who the answer is based off of what
Amanda says. She will say it's me.
It is you.
It's not true, but she will say it's me.
These are easy.
But here's the best follow-up to that.
I'll be a bamboozle.
She says, he does. However... I give him control in the bedroom.
She does.
Jay, you a freak. Give me that pussy.
This was like a freebie for you.
Okay.
Yeah, because he didn't really know the answer.
What, I get one fucking right? Or 2?
I think you got 1.
Yeah. No, I got the chicken Batman.
And the Batman was one. It was really me who gave you that one.
What is the longest you have gone without showering?
I don't know.
I shower a lot, actually. I love being clean. I'd say 3 days.
I mean, you get the free pass again. Because his answer was, I don't know, but I am sure while he was on tour.
Oh, yeah.
Can I just say for the record, he made you sound cool.
Yeah, I did tour in a band. I did tour in a band.
I would have guessed, like, at max 48 hours.
Yeah. See, days. I don't think I should have to take a shot for that because there was give an answer.
You're good.
Yeah, he really give an answer.
You kind of get a freebie on this too because she wasn't.
This whole round's been a freebie.
Yeah. I asked Amanda if she was given $1 million, would she give up a deep, dark secret about you in return?
I don't really think we have that many secrets. I mean, honestly.
She's like, I don't believe you.
Everybody has a deep dark secret.
I know.
Not really. I told you, I got no shame.
If I gave you, not that I have $1 million, let's not get excited about this. If someone gave you $1 million to give up a deep dark secret about Amanda, would you do it?
I don't think she has any. There's nothing that crazy about us.
Wow.
Bullshit.
She really spent 3 days thinking about this answer.
I just,
Ashley, you know, I would go with jab the knife in there.
I would go with no.
She says she didn't know.
Yeah, I don't think. I don't really think there's that many deep, dark secrets. We're pretty pretty open book.
I mean, you two are probably open with each other, but I'm sure there's things about you two
openly
that I don't know.
Hostile opinions.
What's there to say?
Jay's like, we've done it.
I'm
all.
Lazy. She's not. You know, what could you possibly say?
No.
If I asked Ron if Casey could be any Star Wars character, who would he be?
Chewbacca.
Give him the rest.
It's not Chewbacca? How is it not Chewbacca? That's the only noise I make at work. Oh, no, no. Is that the last question?
Yep.
No.
There you go.
Oh,
all of it.
Do it. Bitch, you tried some of this.
I'll take a sip. You know what his answer was?
What?
Jar Jar Binks.
Oh my god, no way. I got bamboozled.
Oh,
your face made me gag.
Do it, do it, do it, do it.
Ron, you're a cunt. The vegan thing was funny, though.
That was an excellent answer.
That's so bad. I don't know how you drank that.
Is that the way swallowing semen feels like?
I don't swallow semen.
What?
They still make you?
What?
I didn't know they still made that model.
You're not a swallower?
Listen, I don't
know. Really surprises me.
No, wait, listen. I would be a swallower if it happened. But he said, and I'm going to be in so much trouble.
No, that just really shocks me. I don't care. Do your thing. Do you.
He said, and I quote, no woman has ever been able to get me off given a blowjob.
Oh, so it's never come to that.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
What?
But you still don't swallow.
I would if it happened.
Oh, so wait, you've never had a guy come in your mouth? Oh yeah, we should talk about it. Cheers, Jason. I'm
put
sorry.
And shut up.
This is a lot, dude.
Idiot.
You if can you do throw it. Up, I'll rub your back. No, bad.
I'm throwing up on you.
That what?
Those questions are bullshit.
That was not. The questions were not bullshit. Rod's answers were bullshit.
Oh man, here we go. Ugh, I don't
I'm gagging.
Make my balls hurt.
I can't watch him. Did he do it? Is it done?
Oh, he did it.
It's done.
Good job, Casey. You're a fucking trooper.
It tastes really good at first.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does.
Oh, it does.
Oh, it tastes like Nesquik.
It has like a kind of a, like a mocha latte sort of thing going on at first.
And then that fucking coating. Just, oh, God.
Yeah, you know what? It's like if you ever drank like soy milk.
I know.
Oh,
yeah.
Shit.
It's not that bad at first, but then the coating, it's like having really sort of bad cotton mouth with a flavor on it.
It's like trying to eat cornstarch.
Yeah, it's just, oh, Jesus Christ.
Yeah, it's like trying to eat cornstarch. It doesn't taste bad at all. It kind of tastes like a mocha latte.
Yeah.
I don't know where you get your mocha lattes from.
Ain't Starbucks. You're
but
a Starbucks
it's
girl,
not
aren't
Starbucks.
You?
Fuck
yeah.
Starbucks.
You're a Starbucks
tastes
girl,
like burnt coffee.
Yeah, I don't.
Fuck that shit.
I had Starbucks once and their pastries were shit.
I love Starbucks and DD.
I feel a coffee snobby today because my coffee pot broke and I had to use my French press to make coffee this morning.
Look at you. Can I put these on the thing back here?
Yeah, sure. Go for it.
Yeah, go ahead. Put it on our wall of whatever.
Wall of shame.
Yeah. Or wall of whatever. Right below the World of Warcraft action figures that Ashley bought me.
That's right.
That was the greatest gift. I was like, you actually know me.
I mean, Jason helped pick them out.
I know, because they hate that I play WoW, but they like it was nice that they got that. They're like, they feed my addiction.
I only hate it because he doesn't spend time with us anymore.
Yeah, I know.
That's such a girl answer.
I am eating dinner at their house tonight, though. So
true story.
Yes.
You We're are having... invited because you don't eat meat.
I don't care.
We're having stuffed shells, right?
Yes.
All right. Turtle and half shell, turtle power.
You guys are acting like this vegetarian thing's like permanent.
No, see, and that's
it is a life change. I
no,
read
it's not.
That Facebook post. It is not a temporary thing to lose weight. It is a life change.
Maybe for my wife. For me, it's trying to like get rid of some bitch tits.
Yeah, don't want those titty sweat.
All right. Follow us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, follow us on Google+, follow us on Patreon, follow us on YouTube. You can listen to us on Stitcher, Google Play, iTunes, TuneIn Radio, and your favorite podcatcher.
Yes. Thank you again, Ashley, for coming. It was fun.
Yes, it's always fun.
Yes, it was fun. And everyone, I want you to spam on Jay's social media, Shania Twain's man, I feel like a woman.
I hate you all.
So proud of you.
I know. Yep.
Fuck you all.
Thank you, everyone. Have a good one.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.